fully agree with Dr. Sanjeev Bagai. He is absolutely right because they have very small number of cases. Number two, there is no point of keeping the bug's name with the name New Delhi. You know, it is bugs are not kept. The names are not kept like this unless you have to publicize that. That is the second issue. Third is that this kind of a bug has been isolated not only from India, but also from Pakistan, from Bangladesh, from Britain. As Dr. Bagai has also said that this patient was a diabetic patient. He has traveled all over the countries and come to India. Now it is very difficult to blame. It is, in fact, it is incorrect to blame that India is the originator and the spreader of this kind of a bug with this kind of an enzyme, and it doesn't make, I personally feel, and there is no point of labeling a bug with the name New Delhi, you know, and four are the places which we know. There might be so many other places harboring the same bug which we don't know today. From where this bug has originated, no one knows.
All right, it's almost like saying calling H1N1 the New York. I believe this is maligning India's medical tourism industry.
I will also like to be apolitical like Dr. Sanjeev Bagai, but as a doctor I can say I've read and gone through this article. There are so many flaws in this article. The number of patients are very less. They have been they are trying to just track down to only one patient who came from Sweden and got this infection. If it is such a rampant infection, then when 4.2 lakh people are coming, why they are not only one person has got infected? So I think that medically it will be incorrect to label it.
I would also like to add, right, just one last